गुरुआनंद जी ने विषय को आपके सामने रखा है और मुझे लगता है कि आप गुरुआनंद जी ने जो कुछ कहा बहुसंख्यकवाद की तरफ काफ़ी तेज़ी से बढ़ रहे हैं और इस बहुसंख्यकवाद के सामने बाकी मुझे लगता है सारे तर्क हो या सत्य हो या वास्तव हो उसके लिए कोई जगह नहीं शायद रही है। अब मैं आमंत्रित करता हूँ मिस्टर हरतोष बल जी को। हरतोष जी,
इन टर्म्स ऑफ आई विल स्पीक इन इंग्लिश बिकॉज आई डू नॉट फॉर वन बिलीव दैट द बैटल विल बी फॉट।
इफ यू स्टैंड अप पीपल विल बी एबल टू सी यू।
आई प्रेफर टू सिट। That this battle can only be fought in Hindi or it can be fought only on terms of Hinduism. This battle is much larger and no language has a preserve over this battle, no identity has a preserve over this battle. There is very little to say about Narendra Modi and this government. I think we all of us know what the problem with this government is, what has happened with the media. I think the Surya Express story was just repeated. The Surya Express story was just repeated by some of my colleagues that I was there about 15 days before for a discussion on the post-Pulwama. It was rare that you could have an open discussion which could raise doubts and questions about what the government was doing. 15 days later, unsurprisingly, those people who enabled that atmosphere at the channel had been sacked and removed. This is the usual story of this government, this is the usual story of the Modi government, and we are living in an era of the WhatsApp university. I was recently in Bombay, a friend of mine was here from Assam. You can go to any part of the country and you will hear the same kind of rhetoric, which is, if Jawaharlal Nehru had not given up the UN security seat, today Modi would have shown Pakistan what the truth of our times was. There is very little you can do to challenge beliefs like that. No amount of writing can change that. So what is the role of the media at such times? What is the media supposed to be doing? First of all, the media's position is a skeptical one. We should be able to report whatever comes our way. But it is also our job to highlight the issues that are central to an election. And I, for one, and I keep hearing this all the time, I do not believe that the central fact of this election is defeating Modi. It is a renunciation of our role as journalists to skeptically look only in one direction. What are you going to defeat Modi with? Who is asking those questions? Did Modi come to power on a platform of Hindutva? If he didn't, what was the platform he came to power on? Why was that platform possible? That platform was possible because of the weakness of the Congress and the opposition. Has the Congress and the opposition learnt any lessons from the weakness of that platform? You turn around and ask them. A senior congressman, in the presence of a young reporter of mine at Caravan, he didn't know that the reporter was from Caravan, was a reporter, is saying that, you know, अगर हमारी सरकार आती है तो मीडिया को टाइट करना पड़ेगा। तो दिस इज वॉट वी आर हेडेड फॉर, यू नो, ये टाइट कर रहे थे, ये हटेंगे तो ये अपनी तरफ से टाइट कर देंगे। दिस इज द लेसन द कांग्रेस हैज लर्न फ्रॉम दीज 5 ईयर्स। इंस्टीट्यूशनल क्या स्ट्रेंथ बढ़ानी है, यूनिवर्सिटीज में क्या करना है, वॉट शुड बी डन विद द एनजीओज, वॉट शुड बी डन विद द मीडिया। आई हैव नॉट हर्ड एनीबडी इन द कांग्रेस एस्पाउज अ व्यू दैट इज डिफरेंट। और अगर वो पावर में आएंगे, क्या 2 साल के बाद वो फिर मोदी को लेके आ जाएंगे? हम लोग और तंग होंगे, वो लोग तो अपना काम, अपनी कमाई करते रहेंगे। सो वेयर आर द क्वेश्चंस टू द कांग्रेस? व्हाई इज द ऑपोजिशन गेटिंग अ फ्री राइड एट आवर टाइम्स? वी आर राइटिंग अबाउट मोदी, द दोज ऑफ अस हु आर क्रिटिकल, बाय व्हाई आर वी नॉट आस्किंग क्वेश्चंस ऑफ द ऑपोजिशन? एंड व्हाई डू आई रेज दिस? बिकॉज आफ्टर ऑल, व्हाट इज हिंदुत्व? लेट अस बी क्लियर व्हाट द सेंट्रल कोर बैटल ऑफ दीज इलेक्शंस इज। हिंदुत्व इज अ व्हीकल for taking a minority, what is that minority? The upper caste Hindu vote, and converting it into a majority by usurping as many of the OBCs as possible as part of that identity and winning an election. If that is the central battle that Modi poses before us, and the RSS is central to that battle, what is the answer to that battle? That is a battle that is being fought by Akhilesh, it is being fought by Mayawati. The Congress is not fighting that battle. I speak as somebody who is an Indian citizen, but also whose identity does not come from Hinduism or the Hindi belt. After Pulwama, I have not heard such negativity about a government or skepticism about its claim from Punjab as I was a reporter in Punjab during Kargil. There is nobody in Punjab today, and this is a state where everybody has relatives in the armed forces, there are people who are very much part of the national security discourse, who today do not believe this government, who do not believe the threat they claim is from across the border. They seem to feel the threat is much more from inside today. Hindutva is alienating not just Dalits, it's also alienating every other minority. In the face of this, what is Congress offering us? What is the Congress offering us? It is also offering us the same vehicle for the same upper caste Hindu ideology. You can call it more tolerant. It serves the same purpose, the same dangers, the same damage. And that is the only option that has been given to a vast variety of people. As a Muslim in this country, what are you choosing? You are choosing between one party that actually wants you dead or quiet in such a way, and the other that doesn't want to take your name, will not put up a Muslim leader and put it forward, and let the term minority be a part of its agenda. So the battle is to be fought on economics, it is to be fought on demonetization, it may be fought on corruption, but we will not talk about identity, we will not talk of caste, we will not talk about Hinduism, its uses and misuses, or Hindutva. And I'm saying it is the job of the media, popular or unpopular, to keep coming back and raising these questions. It is not our job to ensure the victory of the Congress. That is not what the media is there for. It is not our job to ensure the defeat of Modi. It is our job to ask questions, pose out the dangers and threats that Modi represents. It is also our job to point out the dangers and threats this Congress represents or a failed opposition represents. Because if we elect a failed opposition to power, 2 years later we will be seeing a Modi with 400 votes sitting in the center, and we will have no ability to resist any longer. And that during these times. So our threat, our role is simply not to look in one direction, but to look in every direction and be skeptical, while understanding that the real threat is to the ethos of the constitution of this country, not to some Indic tolerance, not to some Hindutva, but to the constitution that allows me, speaking in a non-Hindi language, representing a non-Hindu ethos, to claim that I am an equal citizen of this country, and I am not going to be represented by the Hindi belt Hindu, some hegemony that is going to decide, an upper caste hegemony, what this country should be about. And I think that's the role of the media. Thank you.
Q&A session, I would like to invite Mr. Pankaj Srivastav, who is from